Hello, it's Christine and Trish.
Hello.
It's been a while.
But we're back.
We're so excited to be here. You know what? I was going to see if I could find a flower lay and put it on my head, and I was going to be like, well, hello, all you cats and kittens, and then stare off.
Oh, I should have had a blonde mullet.
Yes!
And a camo shirt!
Right?
Oh!
We could have totally saved that for a future live. I shouldn't have told on ourselves that we were even thinking about that.
Well, you never know what could happen down the line.
True. So, hello, welcome. If you see the little red live up in the corner, then you are watching Christine and Trish live. And if you don't see that live, you're watching us on replay, but still post a question and we'll do our best to get back to you. Our aprons are backwards, but I don't like to flip it around because I have this thing about seeing Trish on this side. I don't know why. I'm just weird like that. So, it is what it is.
And I don't like to flip it around. Because I don't like to flip it around.
I'm just starting my turner. So, I gotta tell you guys, I'm not unprepared, but I'm not prepared. Does that make sense? Like, I'm ready to do this live, but I don't have everything completely, like, set up and ready to go. I just had to, like, hike it up to my neighbor's house to get some pumpkin. Because I have a sick dog, and I needed pumpkin. And I thought I had pumpkin, and I didn't. So I put a shout out to my neighbors, and I'm like, hey, does anybody have any pumpkin? And, of course, the neighbor that responded and said, yeah, I've got some pumpkin, was the neighbor that lived the furthest on my street. And then when I was like, oh, I could just drive up really quick, then it was like, or I could just walk. So, of course, I walked. So,
why?
Well, because I felt like I should. Because okay. I've been cooped up in this house, and I felt like I could walk, you know, and it's only like, I don't know, like 8 houses. It wasn't like
that. That's 7 too many for me.
True.
I don't walk anywhere.
All right, so let's talk about what we're doing tonight. Whoa. As I'm going to just pump out some epoxy and get to stirring so we can gab while I'm mixing.
I can't find what you're looking for.
Here, let me see. Are you on the website? You're on Facebook.
I tried to go to the website.
All right. So I asked Trish to help me out to look up something.
And I failed.
That's okay. We still love her. So tonight we're going to be doing some, hello Carolyn and Barb, we're going to be doing some tumblers with counterculture DIY. I'm so used to saying CC DIY, but for those of you who haven't used their products, you might not know what that means. CC DIY, counterculture DIY, dispersion colors. And I wanted to get this right, okay? So I asked Trish to look this up for me. So if you go out to the counterculture site, can I help you? Yeah, hi, my daughter's here. She's saying hi. So they have multiple things. They have extreme, they have intense, and they have dispersion. And the dispersion colors are water-based. They're a water-based pigment used to disperse evenly. And the intense colors are a nano pigment. So if the regular, here we go. So I can say this right.
You got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
If regular pigments, if this is like to put it in perspective for you, if the size of a regular pigment is the size of a basketball, the size of the intense pigments are the size of a pea. So what does that mean? It's an extremely concentrated, small particle size. So the pigments in the colorants are going to behave differently. So I wanted to point that out because I'm going to most likely just use the dispersions, but I do have some intense colors as well. And I keep looking over because I'm looking at my shelf where I have them. This is what I'm talking about. This is a dispersion color. This is, looks very similar to an acrylic paint, but it is a concentrated pigment, a liquid pigment. So, what is this crazy stuff?
What is it?
What is this? So, I'm not going to sit here and pretend and give you some a bunch of scientific mumbo jumbo. But I'm going to tell you that it is a way to color your epoxy. And depending on how you use it, here's a coaster that I did. And I didn't really do much. I just kind of mixed it into the epoxy and dumped it in a coaster. And I used a combination of dispersions and the intense. And because they're different sizes and different weights, they're going to intermingle and float at different levels. Now that's a very unscientific way to describe it.
And I have a feeling they're going to get the scientific way to describe it now.
No, right? No. I said I'm not going to get all science.
Oh, and I said,
whew. No. So I just wanted to say, like, there. So I'm not going to pretend to be Amy. Amy is awesome, and I've learned probably everything that I'm going to show you tonight from Amy Sadler. I am a member of Hermica Mixology, and that's where I first really started playing around with the dispersion colors, and that is where I had the courage to try that blue and white cup that I posted in the event, in the event picture, and I thought I would show you guys what I did. And actually, we're going to make two cups tonight.
I figured. Are you going to tell the story?
Yeah, is that okay? Yeah. Do you want to tell it?
No, go ahead.
So, there's a really touching story that goes along with the cups that we're making, or at least one of them. Before I get to that, let me pause and finish my thought. The dispersion colors, what some people are doing with the dispersion colors is that they're foregoing the process of spray paint.
What?
I didn't say they're not prepping their cup. They're still sanding their cup and cleaning it. But instead of spray painting a base color, they're using the dispersion colors directly on the stainless steel. So we're going to do one cup like that tonight. And we're going to mix the dispersion color in the epoxy. And we're going to apply it to a tumbler. And then we're going to do the same thing on, we're going to do a similar tumbler on a white base. So you're going to see probably one that's a little more of a hodgepodge of color, and one that I'm going to do more of the streaking type effect that I had with that blue and white. So we're going to do two cups. So the cup that we're going to be doing with like the barrage of different colors, we're doing for a very special person. So Trish has a friend, somebody that she knows, whose mother was in a nursing home and just passed away from COVID. And what makes this story even more heart-wrenching is the fact that she passed alone without her family because nobody could go visit her. And not only was she alone in this nursing home without her family, but the nursing staff, the head nurse, amongst others, have been quarantined in this facility with the patients because there are a large number of patients that are infected. So everybody has been trapped.
Trapped.
I guess that's the right word.
Trapped.
They've been at this facility
2+ weeks.
For over 2 weeks. And people are dying without their family. And Trish's friend's mother was one of them. And so Trish's friend wants to send a cup to the head nurse that was there with her mom when she passed. So that is kind of a sad story, and not something that I don't mean to set the tone so low. But that's one of the cups that we are making tonight, so that you know that it is for a very special person and for a very special reason. So yeah, there's a lot of tragedy. So hello to Rhonda and Deneen. Sorry I didn't get to say hello to you. I was kind of in the middle of my story.
And Devana,
I'm so sorry for your loss. So I just mixed up about 60 mils of epoxy, and I may not use it all. I'm gonna put the camera down so that you can see what I do on these cups. See how quickly I switch. I'm like, I'm going to tell you this really awful story, and I'm going to get all teared up and try not to cry. And I'm like, all right, back to cups. Let's just
make
some cups.
You're like the weather. You're like the newscasters. You know, like how they say, and today it's going to be sunny and bright, but there's been a murder. And
I don't know if that was a compliment or an insult. I'm not really sure.
I'm just telling you what it was kind of like. It was kind of like a roller coaster. Up, 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 up.
Oh, we're going to make some free cups. Oh, everybody thinks it was a really horrible story. Now we're going to make some cups again. Okay, yeah, I get it. Yeah. All right. So let me move my light out of the way, and you can see how terribly dirty my area is. And I'm going to pull you in a little closer. So once I get this to stop falling on me, I hate this thing.
Didn't you just get that?
I did. I replaced my first one I didn't like, and now I'm going to replace this one. Okay, so this is the cup that I'm going to, and it's still moving a little bit. I'm going to try to swing you around. I just don't want you to miss it. So I'm going to apply directly onto the stainless on this one. And I'm going to put this one on the white base. So I haven't really picked out the colors that I'm going to use. To give you an idea, I am a craft hoarder. This is the color selection that we have for tonight.
Oh, Lord.
Yes, I know. I'm bad. I'm so bad.
Devana, I hope I'm pronouncing it wrong.
Devana?
Yeah. Says, we call that changing lanes without a turn signal.
Yeah, that's kind of the story of my life.
Yeah.
That's a great way to put it.
She nailed it.
All right, so I'm going to put a little bit of epoxy in some medicine cups just so that you guys can see the colors. I think what I'll do, so for the angel cup is what we're calling this one, because we're going to put like a guardian angel on it. And I say we, like Trish.
Or you.
You're making it. I just asked you if I could use it for my demo.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just on the base.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put colors on this, and we're going to cover it with some opal glitter. So what you might do with spray paint, we're going to do with dispersion colors, and then put some opal glitter over top of that. And with this one, we're actually going to use the dispersion colors and do more of that streaking design, like in the blue and white cup. Now you can use facet and do this. I opted not to use facet and to use regular epoxy because I talk a lot, in case you hadn't noticed, and I didn't want to get ahead of myself and have my epoxy harden while I was chit-chatting.
Rhonda says you're not a hoarder, you're a collector.
Yes, I think that the art of buying and collecting craft supplies is as much fun as using them sometimes.
Can I toss this?
Toss what?
These.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, thanks. Thanks, Solen. Devana says, it's all about the base. Base, no trouble, ladies. That's right.
So I just grabbed 6 cups. I have no idea how many colors we're using tonight. Probably more. Now, and I'm trying to keep an eye on if there's any questions. I am going to first remove it. I am going to put a very light coat of epoxy just so that my colors will glide a little bit. That is not necessarily a requirement. I think that once you start messing around and playing with, you know, or what type of cup that you're doing, you can do different methods.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
So I'm going to put a very, not like glitter thin coat, but just enough to, just a very thin.
Sandra, we're working on, well, Christine's working with dispersion colors tonight. One's just going to be a Mod Podge of color, correct?
Yep.
And one we're doing,
Streaks.
Streaks.
Like the blue and white cup that I posted in the event.
Yeah, like that one. What she said.
So I haven't decided what color to do that yet. So do you guys have any thoughts on what colors you want to see? I definitely want to use some white because I think white gives you that nice overlapping effect. with the color. And again, this isn't like glitter coat thin, but this is like not thick at all. I just wanted to get some epoxy on my cup.
Where did you get the metal stir sticks?
I ordered them on Amazon. Look for stainless steel beverage stir sticks.
Okay.
Like in barware.
Rhonda Fox wants you to do pink. Shocking! I love you, Rhonda.
Well, I have a couple different colors of pink.
We're getting other things here.
Okay.
Sandra says dark. Rhonda says pink. Riddy says aquamarine.
Ooh.
Devona says coral teal, silver, and white.
Ooh.
Now that is fancy schmancy right there.
Ooh. Okay, so... Alright, so I think I can accommodate everybody.
Woo!
And I don't have a silver, Devona, so we can add some silver glitter to this one.
Ooh, that'd be fancy.
Yeah, we can definitely do that.
What do you mean?
And I technically don't have a coral, but we can maybe, we can play around here. So, I put a little bit of epoxy on my first cup, the white cup. And I've also been, like, hoarding my gloves. Like, I've been literally working with one glove on my hand. Like, this is a special occasion, guys. I've got two gloves on.
Right.
So, all right. So, I heard aquamarine. Yes. But we have that box of sandals.
Yeah.
So, we're just being cautious on our glove consumption because they're hard to come by these days. But I'm just saying it's a special occasion. I've got two on. So, back to what we were talking about. So. We heard dark.
We heard pink.
We heard pink.
We heard aquamarine.
Aquamarine. And then we heard...
Coral teal,
silver, and white. So,
anybody else?
Well, I think we got to stop there.
Oh, all right.
So I think we can accommodate the dark request with some aquamarine.
Oh, yeah.
And...
I'm going to do a shout out that you don't own the rights to the music. That's fine.
Oh, sorry. I've got some music in the background and I don't own the rights to that. I've never had to do that before.
One time.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So the dispersion colors, this is aquamarine, they take a very small amount, and I'm using a very small amount of epoxy to apply these. So I only have a wee bit of epoxy in my cup. The ratio, and you'll hear this with a lot of colorants, no matter if you're using dispersion colors or some other resin dye and such, that you do not want your mixture, you do not want more than 5% of your mixture to be your colorant. So hypothetically, if you had 100 mils of epoxy, you would not want to use more than 5 mils.
Kathy Hawkins in the house.
Hey, but... Kathy, you wouldn't want more than 95 mils of epoxy to 5 mils of colorant, but we're obviously using very small quantities, so I'm gonna literally put like a drop on a stick and mix it.
So that's for real all you need.
Yeah, and this stuff is super ultra concentrated, so this bottle's gonna last me forever. So let's see, looking at my colors here.
You haven't missed anything yet, Kathy. Stick around.
All right,
just beginning.
I have a peach, which I think if I add a little bit of pumpkin to,
ooh,
I could probably get a coral. And I'm totally digging the cool carmine for the pink. And then how about some tsunami for the teal?
I like tsunami.
And we said we definitely wanted white. And I'll show you guys all these once I pull them out. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and for fun I will, what am I missing?
What do you got? White,
teal. Should I add some gray?
Yeah, sure.
Maybe let's not overdo it. Let's just go with 5 colors.
5 is good.
Alright, so I'm going to start with aquamarine. I'm going to try to combine a little bit of the pumpkin and peach to get more of a coral. We'll see how that goes. If that doesn't work, we'll add some different colors. I've got cool carmine, which is a lovely pink color. Tsunami, which is a teal. And I've got white snow. So I'm just giving these a little shake.
Shake, shake, shake.
And I'm going to break my sticks in half because I only, not only am I a hoarder, but I'm also frugal.
A frugal hoarder. Is that even a thing?
Yeah. So I just put my stick in. Now, I'm mixing the white in, and I'm seeing that it is rather, it's kind of milky. It's not the level of opaqueness that I want, so I am going to add just another drop.
Emily's here. Emily's in the house.
Oops, that was actually like
hello,
two.
Emily.
Hello, hello. So there's my white.
She's special, all right.
Are you guys being mean?
No, I was just explaining to Amelia that you are special. That's where
gonna
I
do my...
need to get together. Yes, Sandra, yes!
Got my cool carmine, and again, I'm going to show you, I am trying to show you how little bit I am using.
No, you haven't missed anything yet. We're just starting. Christina's working with dispersion.
I show you how much I'm how little I'm using, and then I add more.
We have somebody joining that's
okay.
Asking if they've missed anything.
So all I'm doing right now is I'm mixing some dispersion colors into epoxy. Dispersion color is from CCDIY. It is a concentrated pigment. So that is the cool carmine.
New person I've never seen before, Tammy.
Yeah.
She says, I've never seen dispersion inks used before. This is great.
So some people would probably ask, well, couldn't you just do this with acrylic paint? Because some people mix acrylic paint into epoxy. The thing that you have to watch with acrylic paint is that it can make your paint very stringy. These dispersion colors are actually made to go into... I put like three drops of the tsunami. Are made to go into the epoxy. So you're not going to... I mean, of course, you can overdo it and mess up your ratio completely, but... Here's your tsunami.
Hillary's on. Hi, Hillary. Hi, Cindy.
And again, just... where'd it go? So this is a coaster that I did with some colors. Where you can get some different effects. I'm gonna move that out of the way so I don't say why. What am I doing with that? I'm gonna put some aquamarine. Did I shake? Yeah, I shook this one. Oh my. I feel like I'm gonna make a mess here. I'm crowded.
Amelia also said, I think you get a much richer color. Game changer.
Yes,
yeah,
I agree.
I agree too. Think the work time is as fast either. Do you?
Well, I'm using regular, so this is the aquamarine. You're going to see it's much, much darker, but when we put it on the white background, you're going to see that it, you'll see the color. Now you can also, you'll notice if you go out on their site, that you can add some like pearl white mica if you want to change this to like a metallic finish. I wasn't planning on doing that tonight. Now that I just saw this peach, instead of pumpkin, I'm going to add some cool carmine to get more of that coral. So I added a couple drops of peach. I'm trying to get like a coral color.
Mm.
Yeah, it's not bad.
That's not bad.
So I mixed some peach and cool carmine and got that color. So this cup that we're doing first is kind of like the cup that I put in the header of the event where we're just going to apply in streaks. So I have my turners going clockwise. Not sure how it looks to you guys. Probably backwards. I just removed my sticks. So I don't know if you guys can see aquamarine. That's my coral mixture, cool carmine, white, and tsunami.
Devonna says, I think you nailed the coral. And Emily likes that color.
Thank you. So I'm thinking I'm going to start with the aquamarine. Now, I have personally experienced the color does, similar to working with micas, the color can pull away from the edges. So I am going to try to pay special attention and get the color down and around the edge. One way to work around that, if that happens to you, obviously, is to base coat the color that you're using. But since I'm streaking white through this, and I want white to show through, I'm not overly concerned for this particular cup. But similar to how I would do a marble, I'm just going to bring my color up through, and my turner's kind of slow. This is my, it is.
Ooh, I'm just seeing it on the delay. Wow. Sorry. Hey Jen, Jen's here.
Hey Jen.
You're getting tons of hearts. People are loving it.
So that is the aquamarine.
It's gorge.
And I'm going to be using a ton of paper towels.
You want me to pull you some off?
No, that's okay. I think I'm going to wait till it comes back around. Now, I am overlapping because I want to create some purple in between the two colors and get them to interact with each other a little bit. Now, the cup that I showed you in the example, I only used blue and white. So if you could imagine, if the cup were divided into four, I literally did blue, white, blue, white. So me squeezing all of these colors into one cup, I'm going to get a different look entirely.
Rhonda says, I love the intensity of the colors. I think it's completely different than acrylic in that respect.
Yep, I agree. Now for this one, I'm actually going to come top down so that I can kind of change the flow, because if you see, I've got much more down at the bottom. And you can adjust this. You can use your finger, you can use a silicone stir stick, you can use different implements, different tools. I'm just choosing to use a gloved finger because that's just me. That's what I'm used to using. I'm saving white for last because what I'm going to do is when I do the white, I'm going to then go back through and add white.
Is that the coral?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I got coral pretty good.
Oh, I think so. Yep. I would say, yeah.
Oops, got some blue up in there.
Does anybody have any questions?
Yeah, sorry, I kind of get in my head when I'm... Now you
Sharon
can see...
Sharon asks, what did you mix the colors with?
I just mixed it into my epoxy. So I applied a very thin layer. Again, not like glitter coat thin, but just a thin coat of epoxy onto the cup. This particular cup was spray painted white. And then I mixed my batch of epoxy and put maybe 5 mils in my cup, and then added my dispersion colors to that.
Yeah. Sandra answered it. Dispersion colors by CCDIY.
Oh.
I wasn't telling you to stop, though. What you were... Never mind.
That's okay. Now I'm coming in and adding white. And I'm going to actually add white into where I put the colors so that I can get some mixture happening. Maybe some cells.
Oh, I like that purple. It's pulling right there.
Mm-hmm. That's where
super
the
cool. Yeah.
The pink and the blue mixed. Now, this is color, so it can quickly become a mess. So I'm going to be very careful because I'm the type of person that I don't always know when to say enough is enough. And I'll just keep going and I'll keep adding. And I want to make sure I give it a cup, give the cup time to work.
You got a pretty large white gap coming up.
Over here?
Yeah.
I actually just put white there.
Oh, okay.
But I can add some.
No.
I can add some color.
You don't have to.
It's okay. Color's good.
I didn't know if that was intended or...
So, this is, let me add some of the... I didn't use a lot of the tsunami. This, you can leave and just let it do its own thing. And this can be the basic, like this can be your cup. Or you can come through and actually add glitter. So my plan, and I'm gonna let this keep spinning for a few minutes and not touch it so I can show you what some of the colors are starting to do. My plan for the silver cup is actually to coat that in glitter. If you guys want, I mean, we can add glitter to this one. I was not planning on doing this particular cup. This one, I just wanted to show you how I applied the dispersion color specifically to that blue and white cup that I posted.
Devona says, looks amazing so far. Rhonda says, it's perfect.
So I'm going to hit it with my torch, make sure my hand is clean.
It's ready to go.
Thank you.
Yep. Oh. Sandra said that glitter may be gold or silver might be.
Yeah, I do like a Milky Way kind of thing on top of it.
Do you need me to get them back?
No, I'm not going to do it right now.
They keep coming up?
No.
Oh.
I'm just trying not to blast everybody with the...
Man, it's a workout.
It is. All right. So we'll let that spin and we'll figure it out. And I'll take you guys down and show you the bottom once we do this cup here. Whew. So we might be able to use some of these in our next cup. Not sure.
Look at that. You got cold blanket down here.
I do. Check that out.
Well, it must be a sign.
Trisha's like, look, you've got gold mica. So again, I'm going to add a thin, ooh, this is warm.
Emily says, that's a huge torch. It's a Burnsmatic 4000.
It is a Burnsmatic 4000. And this epoxy, this is what happens when I talk a lot. I should have put it on the cup.
Oh.
It's okay. It'll be fine. I'll smooth it out.
With your Burnsmatic 4000?
But I will mix up some fresh epoxy to mix some colors in. I'm not going to do it in this. Ugh. So this one we're going to cover with some color. And then we're going to cover in opal glitter. And I talk entirely too much, and my epoxy got a little thick. That's okay.
Got a little angry.
That's okay. It'll work itself out. Ooh, sticky. Oh, so, since this one used beachy...
Hillary Weimer splurged and got the Burnsmatic
8000. I might have to ditch this glove. It's too sticky.
Yep.
Woo!
Get rid of it.
Get rid of it. Okay. Whew. All right, so for this cup, I'm not trying to go for an overall streaky effect. I'm just going to put some color on here and there, but I am going to have to mix up some new epoxy. So pardon me for a moment, and we can figure out.
Emily says, I don't think I need a torch like that. No, Emily, probably not. I don't think you... No, I'd say no to that.
Don't fear the torch.
That's true.
Don't fear the torch.
I feared the torch for a minute. Yeah, so what's the difference between the 8000 and the 4000?
Flame control.
Flame control?
The 8000 has a flame adjuster.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
And I didn't know that, or I would have just bought the 8000.
The Burnsmatic 8000?
The Burnsmatic 8000. Trish makes fun of me because I, when I say certain things, like I have this persona. And so the Burnsmatic 4000, see, I said it without doing it. Like when I say it, I say the Burnsmatic 4000. Almost like I'm on an infomercial.
It's the facial expressions that go along with the voice.
I feel like I'm on that old Shake and Bake commercial. It's Shake and Bake, and I help. With my Burnsmatic 4000. okay, girls. Enough playing around. We got to get back down to business.
She said, I'll be looking at what my son was doing, and I wouldn't have any hair. Emily said that.
That's true.
Rhonda says, I'll probably burn the house down with it. I don't know, Rhonda. We've made it. Couple months with it,
right?
I did. How? Oh, no, that was with the heat gun.
All right, Trish. So I'm thinking for this one, We should use some flamingo, some indigo, some verdant vila, and some sky blue.
Okay, I like it.
So that would be like pink, purple, blue, and green. What do you think?
Sounds very guardian angel like.
So what? Flamingo is a little bit softer than the cool carmine. And sky blue is like the most beautiful robin's egg bluish, like it's not really robin's egg, but it's like a light blue. And verdant vila is a green. And indigo, despite what I've always thought of indigo is like this purple. So those are the colors that I am proposing for her cup. And now I'm gonna also give the disclaimer that this will be my first what?
Cheryl and her shisha, that's how she burned it down with the Burnsmatic 4000.
Oh, shush. No,
that's
don't.
What Emily said.
No, don't say that.
Hillary wants suggestions for a red based cup. I was very close to setting a cup on What? Oh, Rhonda was close to setting a cup on fire with the little $10 one. As it was smoldering.
Well, so here's the thing. With the little butane torch, it doesn't get hot enough. So I think that you end up sitting there trying to go over and over and over again. Whereas with the Burnsomatic 4000, you get a very instant heat and it pops your bubbles. So I'm converted. Like, I'm in the church of CCDIY now, and I'm following their recommended.
Wow. You are.
Like, okay. Seriously, like, if they're making a recommendation about what to use with their products, like, if you pay attention, they're doing it for a reason.
Right? Yeah. Go with it.
All right, so let me move some of these out of the way so we can play with some more colors here.
Yes. I like having music in the background.
Well, not if we get sued.
You already said the disclaimer.
Disclaimer? Yes. Okay, so indigo. Indigo dispersion colors. I did like 4 drops. Oh, so yeah, I started to do a disclaimer. Oh, and every time I start to talk, she laughs. What?
Emily says, I use the Amazon Special 5000, Christine's infomercial voice, in parentheses.
Well, that's what my butane torch was.
What was it?
Amazon Special.
Amazon Special 5000.
It was the $9.99 one from Amazon. That's more like QVC. I should be on QVC with that voice.
For the low, low limited time price of
$8.99. Special offer. Oh my goodness.
What's smoking? Not me, Emily. Not me.
I was like, smoking? What?
Where? Somebody giving me cigarettes?
I thought something was on fire.
Oh. You
goober.
I thought we were talking about cigarettes.
No, we're not talking about cigarettes, Trisha.
Quarantine has me wanting cigarettes.
And her health has her not smoking, right?
Yes.
All right.
Oh, wait.
What?
Emily, are you saying something is smoking on the video? Looks like the epoxy is smoking. Look.
What? No, I think that's just the light coming through the window. Anyway.
Oh, Lord.
So what I was about to say, what I've been trying to say, is that for this Angel Cup base with the splatters of color, I've never actually done that before. So we're just kind of making it up as we go, but that's okay. That's how we,
Emily says the green cup is smoking.
The green cup is not smoking. It's not hot.
The previous green cup. Are we going to catch on fire?
There's no green cup over here smoking. Look. I think she's just messing with us.
Emily, are you messing with us?
All right, so let's go back. Let's focus. Oh, refocus. Focus. So this is the sky blue. Look how beautiful. Look how beautiful that color is. I'm in love with this color. This is the Verdant Vela. Let me give you some more light. Verdant Vela.
Mm. They've decided it's not smoking. It's a reflection.
Indigo.
Howdy, Wendy. She said howdy.
And Flamingo. So again, we're just kind of going for the splotchy color because we're going to put glitter over top of this, and we just want a barrage of colors to go under our opal glitter. So I am just going to improvise and put it on kind of polka dot-ish if that makes sense. We'll see how it goes. Hopefully it works. Nothing like messing up live on Facebook if it doesn't, but I'm not afraid to experiment. So again, I've just put a little bit of epoxy in each of my cups. And
Wendy says, so I still got to get me some of those colors. They're fantastic.
Now, I am doing this on stainless, so you'll notice that the colors are not as vibrant as they were on the white.
Alexa, skip. May I ask, what is the difference between these dispersion colors and using acrylic paints? This is from Barbara Alejandro.
So dispersion colors are a resin pigment, whereas acrylic paint, well, paint has all kinds of other chemicals. And when I say chemicals, so paint's gonna have properties to it that make it harden. So it's gonna change your epoxy. It's gonna change your properties of your epoxy. So often paint will make it very stringy, and typically the dispersion colors will not.
Hillary Weimer said it's specially formulated for epoxy.
That's probably the best way to say it. Thank you, Hillary. I try to walk that fine line of trying to like explain maybe a little more than I should, but sounding like a
I think simpleton. Both ways were effective in answering.
So again, I'm just going around and putting this color wherever I feel the mood striking, because we're going to go over and put glitter over top of it.
Cinder said that first cup turned out beautiful.
Thank you. Now I did a, I haven't posted it yet because she's taking it to work with her tomorrow night, but the Gypsy Leopard that I did for my Make It and Take It, I did these as my base instead of spray paint. And because I used a metallic glitter, I'm not really sure that the overall effect was changed from using spray paint. But I did notice that I didn't have to be as heavy-handed, and I just realized I still have this pointed at me, and you can't see the cup as well. There we go. I didn't have to be as heavy-handed with the glitter, and that there's spots that you can actually see the dispersion colors coming through on the cup. So it's pretty. So I'm gonna let that spin for a minute and see if there's any major issues that I need to fill in. It's okay if there's a little silver showing in places. I'm not worried about that too much, as long as there's not major gaps.
I think Hillary's asking,
Gigi!
I think Hillary is asking for a suggestion on a red-based cup.
So Hillary, I just got, from a dispersion colors perspective, I just got a Freedom Red dispersion color. I'm going to show it to you. I haven't used it yet, but they have Freedom Red. But then I think also in their extreme colors, there's also maybe a red.
She's saying it's spray painted red. What dispersion colors?
Oh.
Thank you for clarifying that.
Oh.
Hmm.
I don't know. I think the red's going to tint any color that comes through.
Unless you do something dark.
But yeah, I mean, like, you could go with the real dark ones. But here, I'm going to take you guys down. Let me think on that, Hillary.
Carolyn.
Let me...
Black and gold, yeah, maybe.
Let me switch you around. I want you to see this up close to the bottom. Now, I did not heat this cup. The colors are just kind of doing this on their own. I mean, I didn't heat this cup. I did hit it with my torch. In order to pop some bubbles. But look at the depth and the dimension in that color.
It's really cool.
So you really get a cool effect, and I don't think that you can get that with acrylic paint. This cup over here, over the stainless, I just applied swirly colors because we're going to put some opal glitter over top of that. So, Hillary, I'm thinking, I think I just turned my phone off. Sorry about that. Hopefully this reconnects.
Yep, you're good. You're on.
Okay. Huh. So, thinking about your red cup with the dispersion colors, I mean, obviously you could add white to it and help more of the colors pop. I don't know. Like, I honestly, I haven't played around with them enough to really give you an educated answer. Anything I say would be pure speculation and a guess. But you can see the difference in intensity of the color based on silver and like putting them on silver and putting them on white.
That, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. That one cup I did for the galaxy, I spray painted it blue and tried using the dispersion colors. Remember?
Yeah.
On top of it.
And the blue completely consumed the purple. But
yeah. But then even like the green. I had to add a different green to the green I had originally used. Because it was completely washed out. Just saying.
I do not know. So we're going to add some glitter.
Which one are you putting on?
I'm going to start with a little bit of mother of pearl.
Yeah.
Some fine, and then I'm going to add some chunkier on top eventually.
Be careful that I don't. Just be careful that
I don't. I will. Okay. I will. I'm going to come from this side.
She says she's struggling with creativity block right now. It must be the corona. Because, you know, Christine and I have been working from home. Well, I'm quarantining with her, I guess, right?
Sorry, I'm thinking. No, you're fine.
Okay. And we thought we would be cupping a lot more than what we actually are. And I don't know if it's creative block or if it's just...
I think there's a certain intensity when you're working from home that, like, you feel like there's this expectation that you're instantaneously available because you don't want people to think that you are, like, just goofing around. No, you're fine. You're fine. I was focusing on the glitter and I wasn't talking. No, you absolutely can say that.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to use an opal that is not one of our preferred vendors. I'm just going to say that right now. No offense to our preferred vendors. This just happens to be one that I have, that I am using.
Oh, Sandra's so sweet.
What'd she say?
Well, Emily had said about wanting to get the dispersion colors, and Sandra's like, yes, buy them all. She's like, you pay? And she said, I can share some of mine. I have them all. She's so sweet.
She is. Don't laugh at me. I'm not good at this.
You really
Shut up.
You really aren't good at that. I'm going to blame it on the southpaw thing.
Yes, we'll go with that.
Cody Varga is in the house.
Cody! Oh, you know what? I'm gonna get up there and get this other color I have. Oh, I'm gonna reach up over.
Oh. Sandra says I do worse. I blow the glitter on.
I tried that once.
Yeah, it didn't go so
no,
well.
No, it did not go well.
It was a hot mess.
Yeah.
Aw, Cody said, I wish I was quarantined with my bestie. Aw. Southpaw's rule. That's pretty.
I'm liking it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm digging it.
Yep. I'm down with it.
Yeah, I said, hey, Trish, you've got a cup that you need to make. Can I play? Can I use your cup as an experiment? Sure, Christine.
He wrote beastie, not bestie.
Oh, I'm really liking this.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Misty. Say hi.
Hello, hello. I am going to, I'm going to take the camera down and show you guys this here in just a second.
It's really pretty.
I'm liking how it's turning out.
Yep, me too.
Don't laugh at my spoon. See, this is why.
I'm so laughing.
Shut up. I like my spoon method. Shut up, Trish. You know what? Yes, I could be doing it on my tilting turner, but...
Right?
But no, instead...
No.
Instead...
We don't put it on the tilting turner.
No, we don't put it on the tilting turner. No, instead...
Hell no.
We put it on...
We put it on with a little spoon and right. Do it a little... Boop, with our finger.
That's right. That's right. Because you know why?
Oh, God. And because you really got a lot on it that time.
I was only going for
what,
a small
like
amount.
Three little sprinkles of glitter? Like three little specks?
You know what? Sometimes you don't need a lot. Okay?
Cody says, once this Corona baloney is over, Jennifer Hensel and I are coming to you guys. Slingshot glitter. Yes! Carolyn, that's brilliant!
All right. I think I've glittered enough.
I might slingshot her with something else.
Hey now, what? Be nice. All right. So now I am going to put this back in the cup here, or the shaker. I used
Whoa, somebody is so sticking up for you.
Good, good. I appreciate it. I thank you. Whoever's sticking up for me, I'm going to...
Devonna,
I'm mm-hmm. going to throw gratitude your way.
Wow, yeah.
All right, I'm going to take you
Sadly,
guys down.
She doesn't see what goes on behind the scenes, how I'm treated.
You are treated royally.
Where's Gigi? She will tell you. She will tell
I'm
you.
I'm turning this around. All right, oh, I got to make my cord longer because this isn't working out. Hold on. I'm pointing at the cups. Okay. Now that I made my cord longer. All right. So you guys remember what this was doing. So we just, this was a stainless steel cup, and I used four different dispersion colors. I used the sky blue, the indigo, the verdant vila, and the flamingo. And I just applied kind of in a splotchy, random way, some color to the cup. Now I did a very thin base coat of epoxy. Not going to say you have to do it. It's just what I did. And I mixed the colors in epoxy. And then I sprinkled a few different opalescent glitters. Because they are not all preferred vendors, out of respect for our wonderful preferred vendors, I'm not going to sit here and ramble them all off. But I have some gorgeous opals on here. In this cup, we just did a white base coat and applied five different colors, one of which we made up on our own, and did a streaky, using our gloved hand, just applied in a streaking motion to get kind of a marbled effect. Now, you could still apply glitter to this particular cup if you would like, but I was just giving you an idea of what you can do with just the color. So there you have it. These are the CC DIY dispersion colors. Applied two different, well, similar, applied similarly, but used with two different, mm-hmm. two different end results.
Yep. That's going to look really nice, that one's.
You will like it?
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me borrow your awesome cup.
Of course.
For those of you guys who joined late, there's an awesome story that goes with this cup. This is going to an amazing person. So it'll kind of pull at your heartstrings. So, and this one doesn't yet have a home. We were just playing. So, you know, looking for an excuse to make a cup.
Two beauties.
That's what we got. Yep. Along with my incredibly messy, look how horrible that is. Don't look at my wow. incredibly messy workspace.
I'm going to have to come in here and clean your space again.
Hey, there's that tilting turner holding my glove.
I'm so glad it's holding that glove.
Right? So, can I answer any questions? Oh, gee, ouch.
Wow.
Can I answer any questions for you guys? Oh, it's going to fall. I am getting a new
order.
Well, Jen was talking about some new mounts.
Jen.
Jen.
Oh, Jen. Hi, Jen.
Yeah, now that I pointed out my dirty workspace. All right, well, I think we're done. So, again, we used a bunch of different dispersion colors from CC DIY. They have lots of beautiful colors. And, Hey, Jen! Hey, Devon. It was holding my glove. It was holding my glove because I've been reusing my gloves.
Could have been holding
my what are the finger cots?
Is that what
no,
they're called?
They're called finger cots, Trish. Trish, put away the finger cots. We're professionals here.
Oh, sorry.
So, if you guys don't have any further questions, I will post a photo of these once they are dry.
Oh, look how that white is. Oh, Sandra's not done.
It was a short live. I need entertainment. We've been live for an hour, Sandra.
She's
I know
missed
you've missed
us.
It. Yes.
People have missed us, Christine.
Yes. I've missed you guys too.
Me too.
We were in another group helping out a little bit, and we're happy to be home.
Yep. Where people love us.
Yes. Where you guys interact with us. We like interaction.
We do. We like to have fun.
So, yeah. So, just wanted to share some things. God, it's still changing. Like, I'm just watching this cup. I keep looking at it. Yeah, if there's anything that we can do, ask questions, post away, and we will be sure to answer them. So until next time, which hopefully will be this time next week, we'll come up with something fun to do and we'll see you then. So until then, have a great week. Stay safe, stay healthy.
Bye, guys.
Bye.